That would explain my men's silence. We meet again. And this time, we will not be interrupted. Come! Show me your power, champions of Eorzea!
To this!
Enjoyed our time together. Alas, all good things must come to an end. Alagahn's secrets await, and there is no profit to be had in remaining here.
occupied.
It would seem we have no choice.
You must continue on. We will hold them here.
Take the eye. It should still hold enough energy to be of use to you. I shall join you as soon as I am able.
Enough talk! Make haste and stop the Archbishop!
Tiamatikin. Etkin? Inches? Nes. An neskasni ith an inesa. One en or I an ith dran an.
Tha I tha ma fo. No less I an is an. Slowest an. Tiamat I loon I Midgar an. Am for an. Cum ul less ith for nesh sen in.
From these eggs did my children hatch. And once they were full grown, they took wing and spread across all the lands of Hydaelyn.
Ni ul meron ith an kin bahamut an. O la ul las an. Wey son an. I there ma fo cum an I an an. Ek mon kin in. Ek mon bahamut esk in. En kayan, kom en inen, asan. Osk nesk bahamut istra en, almais an kay, skash sai ulafa an. Nesk esk nais in, seth alan I ekmon, way I er in. Zale anya, esh I in, esh e, esh ed in. Am les in. Som nist lanen, tai tai ananan. No ma el ules in. Send war in. Ek mon asanin. Santai mikum en.
Unhai den ma. Snidi me.
No mon apan. No one il an, no ed kin. Is kash ul end iles an. An ska ul us el, tai esk is ak I mon el.
Warrior of Light, beloved Son, the Light abideth within thy heart again. Full valiantly didst thou overcome thy many trials, but but glory not in thy success. For the servants of darkness are ever close at hand. Receive of me my blessing once more. And go forth to shine thy light on all creation.
Thou hast broken down the wall I built around thee, and partaken of thy mistress's blessing once more. Strong art thou, mortal, stronger than any other of thy kind. Having looked upon thy deeds, I am convinced thou art worthy to bear her light. The covenant bound me to thee, but 'twould seem our fates were mingled from the first. Though I will not fight thy battles, I will yet lend thee my wings.
will crush you underfoot! In the name of the Emperor! There is nowhere to run! Enough!
the champion of Hydaelyn.
Tell me, why do you despise the primals so? They are the embodiment of mortal will, of mortal desire. Plainly, you desire a foe to despise, and 'tis well that you do, for it is from the vortex of ceaseless conflict that Lord Zodiac shall be reborn.
Through the joining, the world shall become whole again. Then all shall be as once it was, as it should ever have remained.
For the glory of Lord Zodiac.
Your meddling ends here and now, Warrior of Light. It defies all reason.
No. I will not be bested by the likes of them. La Habrea, it is time.
Very well. Let us show these mortals the true power of the Echo. The power to break down the barriers of existence. Become one. That he might regain the blessing of light I had foreseen. But he has grown so strong in it as to deny us our power.
Let us withdraw, Lahabrea. That power remains to us, at least.
So, you harnessed the Eye's power. A pity you spent it all. What will you do now, hero?
So, not even the vaunted Warrior of Light can unmake an Ascian without relying upon mortal contrivances. In the distant past, King Thordon and his Knights 12 fought and defeated Nidhogg. Though the victory cost them dear, they were rewarded with a great prize, the Dread Worm's Eyes, both of which have since been held in the Holy See's safekeeping. The Eye you possess was Nidhogg's left, and long has it served as a source of the Azure Dragoon's might. As for its twin, it has lain here, joined to the person of Haldreth, the first Azure Dragoon. For though he learned to harness its power, he was ultimately consumed by it. Even in death, his body decays not. A pitiful end for a fabled hero. My Ascian friend, long have you and your kind sown the seeds of chaos by teaching mortals the secrets of summoning. But if you assumed that we would meekly serve as your pawns, then you are gravely mistaken.
You would raise a hand against us.
By by taking unto my flesh the soul of the legendary King Gordon, I can become a god!
Not cessation, whose being is sustained by a millennium of fervent prayer and the eyes nigh bottomless reservoir of ether.
What?
Your contempt for man has proven your undoing, Asian. For my first act as God King, I do hereby sentence you die! Issue with my godhood, I shall answer you with my blade.